Well, looky here. You've ranked up to become an engineer. Congratulations. You are one of the best of the best. Just close to recon, after all. Now then, as engineer, you have been trusted with some of the best. As you can see, you even get your own beer. Yeah, it's great. Now then, we may be able to pop one and drink, but we have to always be careful on the field. Being an engineer is the most important. Yeah, you can't get drunk now. Throwing up everywhere is not an option. You are an engineer, and you are respectable. After all, you have the best of the best. You have the Panzer Grenadier's very own Panzer II, and MP40 to boot. Now then, you have some of the best weaponry and utility on the team. Now then, you have ammo for your Panzer II, MREs, bandages, a few tires, some binoculars, car jack, some grenades, and a gas can in every single vehicle, except, I believe, a Kumpelwagen. So, you definitely have a lot, and in turn, you are expected to do a lot. Now, as this private engineer here will demonstrate, we need to be careful with our tanks. So you have spawned one in from orders of an officer, right? Now then, yep, spawn another one in. Let's see. By the way, whenever you get the shovel, or spawn a troop transport. But here we have the Panzer II, and after you spawn this puppy in, as you can see, you need to know how to use it. Now, normally you probably have gone through basic training, but this is just in case. Now then, I will demonstrate this, as I believe this private is not going to do an amazing job with it. Sorry, private. Now then, if you hop in, here you go, pretty basic. It is just a normal vehicle. You have a very small slot, so go in a third person. That's going to be ease of driving. Now then, as you take off, pretty simple. Driving's pretty easy. This thing does turn like a tank, but man, is this thing effective. Now then, private, I have a job for you. Here is your actual job. So, I'm sure that you can figure out how to drive this, nothing too big. So hop in. Okay. Now then, if I'm his assistant, I'm either going to do one of two things. I'm either going to come over here and take the SDZ-7, or I'm going to hop in and be his gunner. Now, if you are just a solo engineer, do not be afraid to just take a tank. Yes, these things are a bit difficult to go solo, but you can always do it. Just be careful and make sure that you're always moving. If you have to stop and fire, make sure that you're not in front of an enemy tank. Now then, as we're coming along here, we will halt. There you go. Now then, let's say that for some reason the dastardly allies have brought up their very own tank. So, let me just get one in. There we go. Look at this thing. It's heavy and it's big. It's a jumbo. Listen, these things are tough. And I don't want to insult the Panzer Grenadiers or anything. But let's see. Take a few shots at that jumbo over there. Alright, that's... Well, yeah, put the entire mag. Good. Alright. Okay. By the way, these things are explosive, so be careful. Don't worry, these normally don't do too much damage, but... Yeah, alright, hold fire. I believe that you put in like 3 mags, which isn't too bad, and you brought this thing down to 77. Now, yes, that has packed a punch, but let me tell you, sir, private, hop out for a second. This is going to get rough. Step away from the vehicle. Alright. One shot from that thing, and let's see how much damage it did. Oh, yeah. 83. Now, you might think, well, that's not too bad, and it isn't. Apparently, this jumbo isn't amazing. But let me tell you that these guys can get off 3 shells the time that that Panzer Grenadier has put all of that ammo into this tank. I'm going to tell you, that Panzer II is not going to last very long. So, you run into a jumbo. Oh no, what are you going to do? Well, you're going to back the heck up. These things are not made against other tanks. And sorry, Private, I'm going to leave you for a second. So, right now, obviously, this is wide out in the open. This isn't a very good place. But if you are out in the woods, or if you are in a base, try to find any kind of cover. Now, turning your back and running is, yes, it's cowardly, but it is always the best option than losing your very own tank. So, if you need to, always be prepared to pull back and let the main infantry, if they have anti-tanks, deal with it. And if not, let the bigger tanks do it. Hopefully, we'll have a Tiger II assisting your push. Now then, that's the very basics of tank training. Hopefully, you'll catch me online at some point and ask me about the greatness of how to actually effectively use these things. Because, Like I said, these are the very basics. But we need to move on. So, let's fix this thing up private real quick. There you go. Doesn't take too long with two people. So, now we're going to show something else that's important. Well, it seems like this private's already fixed up this thing, but let's say, oh no, there's more fire coming on it. Oh, excuse me. Alright, there we go. Oh no, it's under fire. Alright, hold fire now, private. This thing's pretty beaten up, right? It's got one wheel, it's at half health. What are we gonna do? Let's say if this is important, this is a tiger. You know, well, you have your wheels, right? So, tigers don't need wheels, but go ahead and slap those on, and I'll assist. Alright. There we go. There we go, so good as new, right? Well, let's say that for some reason this thing is continuously being under fire. Now, actually here, let me do something real quick. Let's get a tiger in here, right? Okay, here's the big boy himself. Now then, this thing definitely can pack a punch. Let's say that somehow, I don't think it actually can happen, but let's say the tank is blown, or this thing is taking a hunk of damage. Now then, you're gonna take, with permission obviously, or if you're just by yourself, I guess it's fine, to grab one of these tractor half-tracks. Now then, your job with this tractor half-track, and I will demonstrate since the private's already demonstrated this, is to get up and get behind. Now then, sadly, you cannot tow this and the driver. I don't believe you can you can't tow it with anyone inside of it. So, kindly ask the driver to step out. And apparently I'm going to flip this tiger. This is another effective way, I guess. Of course, I'm just joking. Don't. But, excuse me. But, to be careful, make sure to get the person out of the vehicle, hit control, hook on, and drive off. This thing is far speedier than any tiger could ever be. The tiger may be able to pack a punch and can apparently flip a Sherman. But let me tell you, this thing cannot go very fast. So let's say that we pull it out of the fire zone. We'll unhook it. It'll apparently do a few flips. This thing is a bit janky, so be careful. But this is actually a perfect example. Now we can grab our car jack. Oh, I can actually grab it. There we go. Grab our car jack and grab it. Flip it. Oh. All right. Sometimes it takes two. Don't be afraid to headbutt here. All right. There we go. Okay. Good enough. Thank you, Private. So, now this thing is ready and out of the action, and you can fix it up, use your blowtorch, put some gas in this thing, and boom, it's ready to go. Now, obviously, this is a very basic of engineering. You know, there's a lot more to it. But, as of right now, this is really all you need to know. Thank you for watching these training films. I hope they have helped you. And along the way, make sure to get contact with King Koopa, number, or space for any further training if you have any questions. Please thank Cool Koala for helping me out for this. And after all, long live the Fuhrer, and have fun.